listen, and pledge whatever you can. Right after this message, it's time for Over the Edge here on KPFA or KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno, and online kpfa.org.
It's summer, and it's about to get hot on KPFA's airwaves with our summer fun drive coming up, where you can hear KPFA special programming.
Why do we fight?
Oh, I wish we didn't. Sometimes you have to, though.
President Bush was initially supposed to address the Indian Parliament. The members of Parliament threatened to heckle him. So then they tried to fix him up in the Red Fort, but that had too many what would here be called Muslim terrorists. And they tried this auditorium called Vigyan Bhavan, but that was shot down as not being prestigious enough. So eventually he spoke in the zoo.
There is another world. Beautiful heritage of what was called in old times internationalism.
And I think reclaiming thinking has to be part of our new revolution.
I am resistant.
If we learn to wield those weapons of truth and justice, I still remain totally, completely confident that we can yet win.
Tune in to hear more of these voices for change, of dissent, in essence. Visionary Voices, here, starting on Monday, July 24th, on your listener-sponsored radio, 94.1 KPFA.
I am
great news for you. After the television show, I asked Alan Freed if he'd come down to our prom. I just talked to Alan on the phone. He's coming and he's bringing a whole show. So, we're gonna rock tonight.
Rock.
of mine. Oh, me and my baby said, we're gonna rock tonight. Gonna rock, gonna rock, gonna rock, 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 rock. Gonna keep on rocking till the quarter to ten. Come up forever and go rocking again. Oh, me and my baby say, we're gonna rock tonight. Gonna keep on rocking till the quarter to 11 and rock along up halfway to heaven. Cause me and my baby say, we're gonna rock tonight. Gonna rock, gonna rock, gonna rock, 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 rock. Gonna go on rocking till the quarter to 12, having a ball, enjoying ourselves. Cause me and my baby, we're gonna rock tonight. Gonna get to the door about a quarter to one, kiss for a while, what a barrel of fun. Cause me and my baby say, we're gonna rock tonight. Gonna rock, gonna rock, gonna rock, 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 rock. Gonna kiss tonight with a quarter to two, with a heart full of love and a hole in my shoe.
Well, what's the matter now?
This is Over the Edge, KPFA in Berkeley, and we're continuing tonight in our quirky but chronologically correct history of radio called How Radio Was Done, tonight, Part 10.
This is yours truly, Alan Freed. Get your dancing shoes on and welcome to the rock and roll dance party. From New York City, the home of rock and roll, we welcome you to the big beat in popular music in America. And here's the king of rock and roll himself, Alan Freed.
Thank you, Vern Bennett, and welcome to our Camel Rock and Roll Dance Parties. And here we go. Sam the Man Taylor, Big Al Sears on tenor solo, and our band with the Teen Rock.
The arrival of rock and roll in my life was like something that came from another planet. We hadn't heard anything like that sound before. We hadn't heard people making that kind of noise, breaking all limits of politeness.
Well, long talk, that is you, people speech of God, everything that I've done need, oh baby, yeah, baby.
And what was so strange is how so many people responded to someone very weird, like Little Richard.
Thank you.
Here's a name that's synonymous with rock and roll.
Say I look nice when I'm not. Touch my hair as you pass my chair. Little things mean a lot. Give me your arm as we cross the street. Call me at 6 on the dot. A line a day when you're far away. Little things mean a lot. Don't have to buy me diamonds and pearls, champagne, sables, or such. I never cared much for diamonds and pearls, 'cause honestly, honey, they just cost money. Give me your hand when I've lost the way. Give me a shoulder to cry on. Whether the day is bright or gray, give me your heart to rely on. Send me the warmth of a secret smile to show me you haven't forgot. For always and ever, now and forever, little things mean a lot. Give me your hand when I've lost the way. Give me your shoulder to cry on. Whether the day is bright or gray, give me your heart to rely on. Send me the warmth of a secret smile to show me you haven't forgot. That always and ever, now and forever, little things mean a
fresh and tender kiss. Add one stolen night of bliss. One girl, one boy, some grief, some joy, memories are made of this. Don't forget a small lonely fold in lightly with a dream.
He happened to live in the heart of New England's growing plastics industry.
On Wall Street, on a road where nature parks.
Earl talked himself into a job at the Viscoloid Company. He worked there for approximately a year and then decided that he could go into the plastics business on his own.
Earl started Tupper Plastics and made beads and cigarette cases and soap dishes. In 1945, he got his hands on some pure polyethylene pellets, a recently invented wartime plastic. DuPont didn't believe raw polyethylene could be molded. But Earl tinkered with his machines for months and invented the Wonder Bowl and the Tupper Seal.
And he told me the story of how he got the idea of using the seal. He says, I could make a seal that would fit it exactly and would be watertight and airtight. Even though it's actually, I got the idea from a paint can.
Tupperware was an absolutely most unique product. There wasn't anything like it. You know, it shocked everybody that you could put food in this container and it would keep longer and better than anything else. It's better than wax paper, the wet cloth, even the refrigerator.
One day in 1951, Brownie called the company to complain that her order was late again. She insisted on speaking to Mr. Tupper himself. He would improve his business, she told him, if he sold Tupperware only at home parties. He wanted to hear more.
Your lips and mine, two sips of wine. Memories are made of this.
A white sport coat and a pink carnation.
Likely somebody calling up wanting to order some groceries.
Order to go.
Yeah, I'll deliver that on my balloon-tired bicycle. Over the Edge has been very busy over the past few weeks. We have not taken many calls at all. Receptacle programming has been dark, as we say. If it was light, which it isn't, it's sound, so it's silent. But I'm changing my ways tonight. We're going to relax, settle back, space out, take our time as we hike through the 50s. So if any of you would like to contribute, our phone number is 510-848-4425. Be aware, there is a delay. If you're listening online, I don't know how long it is. But if you are listening on the phone, as this person might be, there's also a delay. Yes, there is now a delay on the KPFA phones. For the first time, we have installed a dump button. It's too bad. I hate to see it come. But thanks to Congress and the FCC and recent laws intended to scare the sh out of us, we installed a dump button, a delay, and it's 13 seconds. So if you're calling on the phone, you can no longer wear headphones and use your telephone like a microphone because you'll be listening to us 13 seconds behind. So now you have to listen to your puny little telephone earpiece to find out what real time really is when you call. 510-848-4425. And of course, as always, when your phone stops ringing, you're on the air.
I thought you were just waiting until we were at the era when receptacle programming was done before you started taking calls again. We're almost there.
Well, we're almost there, but never quite. Anyway, it's back.
So the new FCC rules don't go in effect until January, is that right?
I don't know, do they?
I that's what I thought.
Could
I know
be.
You just signed it into law, but I thought it was
yep.
Like many things takes effect later.
Yeah, so we're jumping the gun with our delay right here. Hoping to be so safe nothing ever happens to us. Sort of like life, you know. If you make it safe enough, nothing ever will happen to you.
Well, I'm sorry to see you guys get a delay. I think you were the last show on Earth that didn't have one.
I believe we were the final holdout in all of radio. I don't know of another station, even college stations, that operate without a delay, and we were doing it right up until this year. My God, it's amazing. And I always thought it was a tribute to our, to so many things I won't even list them, but I'm really disheartened that we have installed a delay. I mean, after all, the only things we've ever gotten in trouble for here at KPFA was playing things we fully intended to play all the way through and wouldn't have dumped anyway, going all the way back to, Howell and Ginsberg.
Well, if the Supreme Court ever strikes down the Brownback law, I guess now it is, I hope you take the delay back out.
You know, once they're in, they're real hard to get out. They're like taxes, so I don't know. I kind of doubt it. They'll just leave it to be safe. Safe. Safe.
Well, I'll keep hoping.
Okay. Yeah, it makes a phone access for local people a little different. It was really cool when it was real time on the phone, and so you could listen to your radio and hi-fi as you called and hear yourself in stereo and all that good stuff, but that's all gone now. Thank you for listening. Thank you for calling.
Just about. Go ahead and move.
And invited her to Massachusetts. And she convinced him that this was the way to go and that he should pull out his Tupperware out of every other place and go strictly on the party plan.
That fellow in New York who blew up his building, he died. He committed suicide.
Over real estate.
He succeeded in his quest. He showed her.
What was his quest? To die with his real estate?
He wanted to deprive his soon-to-be ex-wife of the home that he hoped to die in.
Oh, yeah.
So he died in it anyway. Well, he died. He initiated death.
Clytemnestra's daughter.
You're going to have a delay. Well, you don't have to act on a delay, though.
No, you don't.
Slap me.
Wait a minute. You mean they're gonna have a digital delay on everything that says you can't talk to your radio in real time? Well, that was a problem anyway with feedback, really, wasn't it?
No, not really.
Feedback? I remember initiating feedback accidentally while talking on the internet.
Yeah, once in a while. Yeah, that was the old days. But the good part was if you wanted to call up and sing with something I'm playing or anything like that. In other words, interact real time.
Well, the phone is real time.
The phone is, yes. But your speakers...
You can still interact in that sense, but yeah, what a...
Hardly hi-fi, though.
Well, I understand also there was some work to... they're worried about now audiences in sporting events. The FCC is demanding to go through tapes looking for somebody, holding up a sign or some wayward real-time comment by some fan. I mean, maybe it could evolve into a form of protest where fans deliberately spell out obscene words at random moments and try to at least screw things up.
If you are convinced that you're going to get the car, go clean the garage. Yeah.
Hey, let's see. My granny, you got me cornered there, ain't you?
Yeah.
Better answer the phone before they run our batteries down.
Oh, tell her about this. Give me that. Give me that. No. I'll have to fix it.
Now I remember why I stopped taking calls.
Well, you answer. You're the closest.
And a pink cornet. with me you'd go. Now you've changed your mind, it seems. Someone else will hold my dreams.
Well, what's the matter now?
Oh, nothing.
Well, why? Sport coat and a pink carnation. And in a blue, blue moon.
A white sport coat and a pink.
You told me long ago.
This is the Universal Media Network.
With me you'd go. Now you've changed your mind, it seems.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
Do not say hello. That's the quickest way to get disconnected. Don't say hello.
If there's a beaver between a woman's legs, then what's between a beaver's legs?
It would definitely be better for all concerned if you would not hang up on me again and just listen to this and work with it and deal with it.
I don't have time.
Sure you have time.
No, I don't. I'm completely pressured here to keep going with something interesting. I'm dedicated to that. So if you don't have anything interesting...
Who decides what's interesting?
And who can judge that better than I? I have to move on.
On to what?
No, it's a crapshoot. You never know what's going to happen. If I don't happen to like what you happen to be doing, I can cut you off immediately. I still reserve the right to edit, that's all. But give it a try, and if you get
small negative land recordings.
If you get hung up on, try again. That's the beauty
that's
of it.
I do, and you keep picking up again, and I like that.
Yes, I will continue, and you should continue trying. However, whatever you're doing now, it isn't interesting.
You don't think that's interesting?
No, I actually don't. I would say look into that first 5 seconds. Make it really good, and then I might stick with it. But it's a little hard to hear. I don't know where your audio is coming from.
It's a very low tech. Bye.
...13-second delay. My God.
Don't worry, I won't use it.
You know, you should just fast-forward the history of radio to this terrible moment.
Well, this is what it's come to, isn't it?
Yep.
All right, now that's interesting. A motorcycle. Virtual icon of the 50s. This is How Radio is Done, part 10 tonight, and we have reached the 50s.
That boy gonna come to town singing that black music and gonna run our children crazy.
Slap me. Make me. The divine.
Bye.
Procrastinator.
Procrastinator.
Louder, please. I can hardly hear you.
Procrastinator.
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 Take my conglomeration hold.
Take my conglomeration hold.
Help me.
And re-circumcise my soul.
Re-circumcise my soul.
So that I will love thee.
If I give my heart to you, will you handle it with care? Will you always treat me tenderly?
The production department has a multitude of duties to perform. Primarily concerned with planning and preparing the programs to go on the air.
Will you give me all your love?
Sound effects.
Will you swear that you'll be true to me?
Add realism to dramatic programs. And are produced by specialists in a small, although very interesting field. Actors and actresses perform for unseen audiences. And control men skillfully operate the apparatus which mixes sound effects, music, and dialogue. The best the world has to offer in music, drama, and comedy may be enjoyed in one's own home. Radio's greatest application is in broadcasting mass entertainment.
Answer till you do. When you promise all these things to me, then I'll give my heart to you.
Many programs are broadcast over radio networks. And telephone lines are employed to connect the studio with the various stations. As the program may originate in a studio at New York or Hollywood, the use of telephone wires makes it possible for stations thousands of miles away to broadcast the program. The master controls are operated by men who have advanced from the ranks. Their work requires perfect coordination of mind and hand. For station hookups must be made on the split second. During the short period allowed for station identification, telephone lines which have been set up in advance are connected to feed the program to the network stations.
Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Shoo-doop, doop, doop, shaboom.
Doing doo-wop came about when I was in my teen years. I met a couple of school pals that were singing, and they found that I could sing a bit, and I joined the group, and we started singing on the corners.
I'll be home my time. Please wait there for
Got to Jerry Lee and Mike Stowe, they went to the kettle drums, dum, dum, da, 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 da. I said, oh my God, what do I do with this thing here?
There's a man in town, all the women know. He goes by the name of Nosy Joe. Don't care if they're married, he takes his pick. Long as they're women, he's ready to stick his big nose in their business. His big nose in their business. That's Nosy Joe, the nosiest guy I know.
And he did. You know, the era and the business were made for each other. Women didn't have a car to get around anywhere, so we sat home all day and we took care of our kids. So a Tupperware party was the social function. It was the way to get away from the kids for a few hours during the week.
Nosy Joe, the nosiest guy I know.
In the city, we lived in an Italian area. Probably could have walked down the street and had three Tupperware parties that week. You didn't even have to get in your car. Most of them would be in apartment buildings. Apartment, three family deckers and stuff like that. Walk-ups.
When I sold as a dealer, yeah, I traveled lots of miles. I was 13 miles from the closest little town. And then I worked on a farm neighborhood, 25 miles from the next two towns. And I preferred to hold three parties a day.
He's the nosiest guy I know.
rocking. Vocal groups. Here are the Moon Glows, and I knew from the start.
Catch her with his car? Well, here he is to tell us all about it with a brand new automobile, Chuck Berry, and you can't catch me. Way too fast.
like a coup.
Chicago, Illinois. Here are the fabulous Flamingos to sing Would I Be Crying?
I can't be crying. Can't you see that I'm crying? Would I be I were lying to you? My heart's about to break. I regret making my mistake. My love for you burns the same, and my tears can't put
okay, it's a four-bar intro, and I didn't know nothing about counting bars, and they showed me, so it says count one, two, three. So they taught me how to count bars, and this is a four-bar intro, and then start singing.
Maintenance of radio broadcasting equipment employs a large number of workers and so is technicians.
What a girl 17 did to me, Lordy,
Lordy. It is their job to see that the apparatus is kept in perfect working order.
She made me take some wine.
In the stations, we find these men at work on the amplifiers and on the power equipment.
Bam, 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 bam.
They are not developing new methods or devices, but are maintaining those which have already been developed by the engineer.
Well, we started in the kitchen. Man, we really had a ball. We rocked on through the parlor. And we moved out in the hall. We were doing the Bam-a-lam, 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 Bam-a-lam.
Radio engineers are men technically trained in the field of electrical engineering as applied to radio and communication.
On that morning, she said I had to be her man. She had a father waiting for me with a shotgun in his hand.
They have brought about the high degree of perfection now attained both in broadcasting equipment and in radio receiving sets.
What a girl 17 did to me.
From Maine to California and up to Montreal, down to dear old New Orleans, you'll hear our friendly call. The biggest stars from here to Mars will brighten up your radio.
Responsible, receptive, reusable. This is the Universal Media Network.
Rumors on radio, totally. You lost the ear note. On radio, totally.
You lost the ear note.
On radio, totally sincere. He led his JW. Alan was one of the most persuasive performers on radio, totally sincere and believable. Ear checks, I think, prove it.
Come on, King Doctor. Do it. Come on.
All right, Moondog, get in there, kid. Howl it out, buddy. See Joe Davis sitting over there. Don't let him near your bones, kid, or then all those Moondog bones will be gone. Joe's a wonderful guy. It's always grand to see him. Makes some wonderful records with those crickets. Otis Blackwell, music publisher, and he's been around this business for a long time. Hello, everybody. How are you all tonight? This is Alan Free, the old king of the Moondoggers, and it's time again for another of your favorite rock and roll sessions, blues and rhythm records for all the gang in the Moondog Kingdom. From the Midwest to the East Coast, we're going to be saying hello to a lot of folks who've written to us tonight from all over the Moondog Kingdom, all around the Cleveland area, Newark, New Jersey, New York City, Long Island, wherever you are. And I hope you folks have a good supply of good old Aaron Brew on hand. It's the greatest beer of them all, Northern Ohio's largest selling beer, and it's perfectly balanced for good taste and flavor. So enjoy Aaron Brew as you enjoy The Moondog Show! This is WJW, WJW-FM in Cleveland.
Hello, everybody. How are y'all? This is yours truly, Alan Freed. Get your dancing shoes on and welcome to the rock and roll dance party.
Yeah. Bored with the current hit parade, young people began tuning their radios to stations that played a more exciting kind of music. Black rhythm and blues. Gradually, records by the top black artists began showing up on jukeboxes where white kids congregated.
everybody. How are you? This is yours truly, Alan Freed, welcoming you to the big beat once again.
Eventually, a few white DJs began playing rhythm and blues records specifically for teen audiences, some using the term rock and roll to hide its black origins. Among the most prominent was a Cleveland DJ, Alan Freed. Freed played all types of R&B records, but he was partial to the smooth sounds of black vocal harmony groups.
Life could be a dream, life could be a dream.
And all that's going in my mind, at the same time I have all these strings getting ready to do bits and pieces and the kettle drums going. So I...
Elvis came out and they would say, that boy gonna come to town singing that black music.
But rather than promote these unknown groups,
they're gonna run our children crazy.
The major record companies found they could sell more records if the songs were re-recorded by established white groups.
I was a bit off, but I knew once I started singing, it was their problem to fix.
Now every time I look at you, something is on my mind.
Da, 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 da.
If you do what I want you to,
baby, we'd be so fine.
Known as cover versions, these records were heavily promoted and almost always surpassed the original recordings in sales.
Tell me I'm the only one that you love. Life could
they did represent a new sound, but it wasn't rock and roll. The time had come for a white performer who could adapt rhythm and blues without losing its vitality.
That would be me. I'm Izzy Isn't, and this is How Radio Was Done, Part 10 tonight. Traveling through the 50s. At this point, this is KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno, KPFA.org online. It's Over the Edge.
Hey, Steve, we must be out of our cosmopolitan mind. We should be getting some sleep instead of coming here.
Maybe so. But something's getting these people out of their houses. I'm going to find out what it is.
It wasn't mine. All I have to do is, he said, count four bars and start singing.
There goes my baby, moving on down the line.
They aspired to dare to put strings on and orchestral percussion. I mean, this was unheard of. If you didn't have drums and honking horns and a saxophone, doo-wah, 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 what kind of record were you making?
Well, it evolved during rehearsals. I came up with this line, which sounds like Borodin or Rimsky-Korsakov, because it felt good.
Ain't gonna run our children crazy.
In 1952, a small-time country and western band from Chester, Pennsylvania, began playing a curious mixture of rhythm and blues and country swing.
With no sense of distance, no sense of questioning, just, of course.
And Jerry said, that sounds like violins. And I said, well, why not?
This work of improvement and development is continually being carried on by the relatively small number of highly trained specialists who are radio engineers.
Wherever you are, I miss you, I miss you.
Yes, I've been waiting all my life for this.
Devil or angel, please say you'll be mine.
I never knew it.
Love me or leave me.
among the top positions in radio.
Your smile is divine.
These positions have been filled by men without professional training.
Devil or angel,
but today, there is little chance for a man to become a radio engineer without training in a first-class engineering school.
Devil or angel, there whichever you are.
They've been stuck to their guns, and they made this record, I don't know, with perhaps 20 strings, with the cellos doing it, da-da-dee-dee-dee-dee-da-da, which was a steal from Beethoven, and this and that. And they have all these classical flags and signatures and timpanis and hair drums. Boom, 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 boom.
Devil or angel, please say.
Assembling and inspecting radios as the work is not heavy.
My father had a sort of breakthrough once, as I recall, where he realized they had their fads too. When he was a young man, maybe older than 13, but when, everything's upside down, when the music goes round and round, and it comes out here. Well, I heard this, and he said, this was a wild song that we had when I was a kid, and I said, yeah, that's wild, you know.
You understand me? Because this black music was so intense. It was so full of power and rhythm. It was so full of that fervency. It had it going on.
White America and some black America wasn't ready for it.
And remember, for real enjoyment, all you have to do is pop a cap.
Take a nice long sip.
Boy, that stuff is really here. Aaron Brew 1002, the brand new beer.
When you're thirsty.
How about it, folks? Pop the cap and live it up as we enjoy your favorite blues and rhythm records wherever you are in the old Moondog Kingdom. Well, here's a letter from Korea. Hello, Moondog. My sister lives in Cleveland and listens to your program every night. I'm in Korea now, but I'd like to have you play a song for me and dedicate it to Mrs. Bernice Taylor and all her friends.
This story is writhing with communist music.
And this comes from Airman Harvey Sanders in Korea. Be sure to write to the men and women in the armed forces as often as you can, folks. You know, there's nothing worse than answering mail calls and not hearing.
To construct an small accelerating tube in which we used reaction deuterium plus tritium. That was exactly the reaction which is used in nuclear, in a hydrogen weapon.
The whole hog.
It was new. It was something that Jerry Lieb and Mike Stola had came up with, a new concept of black music and black singers. And it took off, and it just never stopped.
You can dance.
But Benny King's career with the group was so brief that on television, a fellow drifter had to lip sync to King's vocals.
So die.
Within a year of the American explosion, the Soviets were ready to test. The nuclear age had entered a new era. Both sides were now armed with weapons that could destroy
the human race. A series of seemingly logical decisions had brought us to a chilling paradox. From this time forward, to protect ourselves, we would risk annihilation.
In Washington, top defense officials of the nation gather to discuss the gravest world crisis since Poland and Pearl Harbor. The unexpected entry of 300,000 Red Chinese across the Manchurian border may well precipitate World War III. President Truman voices his accusation of Red imperialism.
If the United Nations yields to the forces of aggression, no nation will be safe or secure. If aggression is successful in Korea, we can expect it to spread throughout Asia and Europe and to this hemisphere.
Later, to reporters, Truman hinted that America might use the atomic bomb in Korea. The U.S. general in charge of the U.N. forces, Douglas MacArthur, was known to favor using atomic weapons. Following atrocities against captured American troops, MacArthur's top line attracted growing support.
We are dealing with mad dogs. We have no regard for morals, human life, or decency. We must treat them accordingly. I urge that the atomic bomb be used if it can be used efficiently. These dirty communists should be shown how tough war can be. In my book, one American boy is worth more than all of Asia.
I became the busiest commie side of the Kremlin.
God, they simultaneously deny every virtue and every value that originates with God. The second law of communism is that man is a material machine. He is matter in motion and nothing more. Man is a body and he is completely describable in terms of the laws of chemistry and physics. Man has no soul, no spirit, no significant individual value, no continuity of life. He is entirely an evolutionary product and subject to the modification, adaptation, and transformation by the applied established laws of animal husbandry.
Brownie sent a small army of Tupperware ladies out across the country.
The Universal Language League was organized, and I was appointed chairman. Our goal? Music without politics.
Six times six is 36. I ain't gonna hit for six more licks. We're gonna rock.
This new music soon attracted an enthusiastic following up and down the New Jersey shore. When one of their recordings sold 30,000 copies, the future looked promising for Bill Haley and the Comets. But then, they recorded another song.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. But you got to rock out. Join me, hon. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes one. We're going to rock around the clock tonight. We're going to rock, rock, rock.
Rock Around the Clock was just a moderate success when first released in 1954. But its subsequent choice as the theme song for the movie Blackboard Jungle not only made the song the year's biggest hit, but catapulted Bill Haley and rock and roll to national attention. Given kids everywhere a music that spoke their language.
How much time do we have? Minutes, days, months, years? We don't know. But this we do know. Civil defense is everybody's business. It's a big job getting civil defense organized to operate efficiently. But then atomic attack is disaster on a big scale.
But for the deterrent of the atomic bomb in the hands of the United States.
To meet its NATO commitments to Western Europe, the United States looked to its nuclear bomber force as a cheap yet powerful solution. The new B-36 intercontinental bomber was designed to fit the strategy exactly.
The big bomber had a much greater carrying capacity than any other aircraft so far produced. There was room in the four big bomb bays for 100 500-pound bombs. Or, when tremendously big ones were needed, the cargo could eat two bombs, each weighing 21 tons.
With the building of the long-range B-36, the United States could now threaten targets deep inside the Soviet Union from bases on American soil.
We can and must get the job done if we are to survive. Just imagine, if only one atom bomb were to be dropped on an American city, say it's your city, thousands of persons would be killed instantly. Many would be trapped or buried in wreckage.
American imperialists manufacture atomic bombs.
Streets would be blocked by rubble.
Waving their atomic bomb, they are attempting to frighten mankind in order to achieve world domination and to establish their way of life all over the world.
Great fires would start.
This so-called American way of life.
Dozens of fires in a matter of minutes in many places at once.
To counter America's nuclear diplomacy, the Soviet government supported a worldwide peace campaign condemning atomic weapons. But the Soviets had also been hard at work on a far more effective strategy, getting a bomb of their own.
Then, too, a large part of the city's food supply might be knocked out. The water supply might be cut off. Normal communications might stop. Certainly, transportation would. How much time do we have to prepare?
Now, the communists know we Americans are conditioned to respond to certain word impulses.
Shut up, shut up.
precious love will be born.
Too. That's the original Atlantic version of It May Sound Silly. And Mom, news of a great sale.
You save, save, save when you buy, buy, buy. At L.B. Spears, here's the reason why.
The largest home furnishing chain today.
L.B. Spears, number one USA.
Home maker to millions for 96 years.
You save, save at L.B. Spears.
Yep.
We don't know. But this we do know. Civil defense is everybody's business. It's your business.
You save, and you'll never buy better or save more than right now at Ludwig Bob and Spears, particularly if you rush for this super value radio special. Listen, for a limited time only, record cabinets, beautifully built, spacious, solid hardwoods, finished in rich, glowing mahogany, price last, reduced from $16.95 to an unbelievable, unbeatable $10. They're a full 18 by 16, three generous compartments plus an ample shelf, and the sides are open fretwork. This is for you. You won't hear about it anywhere else. You won't see it advertised anywhere else. No more dusty, cracked, or broken records. Get this record cabinet worth $16.95 for only $10 now at Ludwig Bauman Spears. Take weeks to pay. Ask for this radio special at all seven Ludwig Bauman Spears stores. Now, Helen Capps of Washington Irving Girls High Y writes to tell us that they're giving a dance in Tarrytown on March the 25th. And it's going to be called the Friday Night Rock and Roll. The dance will be held at the Washington Irving High School Gym from 8 to 11 p.m. with refreshments. And all proceeds of this dance are for our March Project for World Service. Louise Erickson, President. Carol Vincent, Treasurer. Joyce Cole, Secretary. Doris Adams, Chaplain. And good luck to you, Helen and girls, in another worthy project undertaken by a fund fine bunch of teenagers, and I hope you have a wonderful rock and roll time on Friday night. You know, it just goes to show you how much a lot of these wonderful kids do for other people all the time and have to take the brunt of all the attacks. And the most sickening thing I've seen in a long time is the marquee of one of our prominent Broadway movie theaters showing the picture called Blackboard Jungle, which is taken out of a paper magazine and transformed to the screen, called The Bold Story of the Teenage Terror. And I think it's probably the most sickening thing I've ever seen. There are good and bad among all ages and all groups of people, but it's certainly a shame to single out the teenagers in this country and make everybody look at them just because they're a teenager. It happens to be a sin. Teenagers I've been dealing with for 13 years are the greatest and most wonderful age group in America. Since when has it become a crime to be a teenager? Well, let's get off that and get on to something really exciting. Here's Bill Donnell's Label X record of A Million Fangs.
Hi, everybody. How are you? This is yours, Julie Allen Freed.
Rock and roll have caught on fire. The man who created the spark and fanned the flames was Cleveland disc jockey Alan Freed. It started at Cleveland's WJW radio station on Freed's Moondog Show when he began spinning black R&B records to his predominantly white audience. The show became a hit. Freed was the visionary who almost single-handedly transformed America's musical tastes by integrating the radio airwaves for white and black audiences alike.
Oh, what a night to love you, dear. Oh, what a night to hold you near. Oh, what a night to squeeze you, dear. That's why I love you so.
Died a broken and forgotten man. One of many casualties in this horrifically predatory business of rock and roll, Alan Freed, one of the first luminaries, died broken and forgotten and alone.
New York called with the opportunity to bring rock and roll to a much larger audience. Freed took his Moondog Show to 1010 WINS. Freed found a way to take the rock and roll trend one step further. He began producing live concert shows in movie theaters with some of the biggest R&B acts around.
Hello, everybody. How are y'all? This is yours truly, Alan Freed. Get your dancing shoes on and welcome to the rock and roll dance party. City, the home of rock and roll, we welcome you to the big beat in popular music in America, brought to you transcribed. And here's the king of rock and roll himself, Alan Freed.
Thank you. Thank you, Byrne Bennett.
Welcome to our show. Here we are again. And now comes the originator of one of our great songs of the past year, Laverne Baker and Tweedledy Dee. We'll be right back.
heart goes lickety-clack. Green lead, green lead, green lead. Green lead, green lead, green lead. How you gonna beat that honey you got? Well, the hunky's a beast fight. I'm going my honey tonight. Green lead, green lead, green lead.
Sang it for you.
But right now, here's a gal who not many months ago started all of America rock and roll dance conscious. And here she is, the originator of Dance With Me, Henry, Etta James.
Hey, baby, what do I have to do to make you love me too?
You got to roll with me, Henry.
All right, baby.
Roll with me, Henry.
Don't be baby.
Roll with me, Henry.
Any old time.
Roll with me, Henry.
Don't think so much.
Roll with me, Henry.
All right.
Better roll it while the rolling is on. Roll, 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 roll. While the cats are bawling, you better stop your stalling. It's intermission in a minute, so you better get with it.
All right.
Better roll it while the rolling is on. Roll, roll, roll.
make up your mind.
Roll with me, Henry. You better roll it while the rolling is gone. Roll on.
And right now we'd like to introduce Mr. Count Basie, the star of our show with his great orchestra, and Mr. Jack Devaney, the West Coast editor of Cashbox Magazine. Mr. Devaney has a special award to make to Count Basie. Mr. Jack Devaney.
Count, in a recent poll of the nation's jukebox operators, which was taken by Cashbox Magazine, Count Basie Band was voted the top rock and roll band in the country. And it gives me great pleasure now to present you with the 10th Annual Cashbox Award.
Well, that's wonderful.
Yeah. Congratulations, Count Basie.
Well, thanks for the gang and myself. Thanks.
Thank you, Count Basie. And thank you, Mr. Jack Devaney of Cashbox Magazine. And now, it's hard to say know what to say in introducing our next act, because this is undoubtedly the top-notch rock and roll vocal group in America. The top-notch vocal group in any field of music, with three tremendous number one record hits in a row, and now on their way to the top with their fourth consecutive smash. Here are the Fabulous Platters and the Magic Cut.
Makes me glow so much. It casts a spell.
Whose roots were a vital part of rock and roll.
Magic touch.
Luckily, I was in New York in 1957 and got to go to a couple of the Alan Freed rock shows. And I remember the first one was Buddy Holly, Clyde McFadder, Big Joe Turner, Johnny and Joe, the Everly Brothers. I mean, it was an amazing show. And that was my first experience with a major interracial situation. The audience basically was about half black and half white. And that was my first experience of being around a lot of black people. And it was a pleasure. We were all just kids. I mean, there was never one racial incident. I mean, we were all just kids who loved rock and roll. And it was like, I mean, that taught me a lot.
These live shows would be Alan Freed's first step on the road to Hollywood.
Now, nail down the roof, gang, because here's a new act to blow it right off. The sensational Jimmy Cabello and his House Rockers and the Big Beat.
Where he broke the rules by featuring both black and white musical acts in the same film.
And then they would take me and say, do this song.
There is a rose in Spanish Harlem, a red rose up in Spanish Harlem. It is the special one. It's never seen the sun. It only comes out when the moon is on the run and all the stars are blue.
Here's the most
rock
and roll. A bold move in 1956.
Used to sing the wide open spaces that used to groove so soft and sweet. But now to be real up to date, shout it out with a big, big beat. Everybody sing with a big beat.
I see you gotta be joking.
Nail down the roof, gang, because here's a new act that could blow it right off. The sensational Jimmy Cabello and his House Rockers and the Big Beat.
Alan Freed's rock films generated massive record sales and kept the movie theaters packed. But not everyone loved this new phenomenon. Religious groups called rock and roll a moral menace.
This rock and roll rhythm is filled with dynamite.
I know the evil feeling that you feel when you sing it. I know the lost position that you get into in the beat. Well, if you talk to the average teenager of today and you ask them what it is about rock and roll music that they like, and the first thing they'll say is the beat, the beat, the beat.
Rock and roll is cool, Daddy, and you know it. That music sends me, man. It sends me. You gotta dig that music all the way.
That was crazy music, man. That's big, Jack.
The 1978 movie American Hot Wax touted Creed as a hero, and even legendary rocker Chuck Berry put in an appearance in memory of his old friend.
1959. You know, they didn't understand it. Hey, what is this? You know.
That we wait for every week. The winner of our rock and roll talent contest for this week.
Alan Freed lit the fuse that ignited a nation.
Boy, you just can't stand to watch a bunch of kids have a good time, can you?
Yes, I actually worked on the bio based on Alan Freed. It was called American Hot Wax. And it was a flawed movie, but actually better than most. I think in retrospect it holds up pretty well. I think it does capture the essence of rock and roll.
I can't stand what you're doing to these kids.
Dory?
Yes, sir.
Is there something on your mind?
As a matter of fact, there is. You see, Father, I went to the dress shop today, and Miss Silky told me that we didn't have a charge account there anymore. And, well, I've just got to get an evening dress for the prom.
An evening dress, huh?
I saw a beautiful one there for only $30.
Only $30? Do you realize, young lady, how difficult it is to earn $30?
I know. I need this dress so badly.
Well, when is this dance of yours?
2 weeks from Saturday.
When's the latest you can order the dress?
Oh, about 3 days before the dance. Why?
Well, tell you what I'm going to do with you. Now, dress is $30, huh? All right. I'll give you $15 if you earn the other $15.
Oh.
Maybe when you find out how difficult it is to earn money, then you'll spend it a little less freely.
Where am I going to get $15?
Well, Dory Graham, how are you?
Very well, thank you, Mr. Bimble.
Sit down. Well, now, Dory, how can I help you?
I'd like to borrow some money.
What?
Well, isn't that what banks are for?
Yes, true. But we don't lend money without business references, collateral.
What's collateral?
Collateral? Well, that's something that people pledge that's worth as much as the amount of money we lend them.
When someone puts money in your bank, what do you do with it?
Well, I don't really know.
Do you mean to tell me, Mr. Bimble, that you take people's money and don't know what you do with it?
Well, of course I know what we do with it. What I mean is that I don't know where any particular deposit goes.
You mean the deposits are all mixed up?
No. They're kept in order by bookkeeping. Double entry bookkeeping.
You keep two sets of books?
I do not keep two sets. Oh, Dory Graham, let me...
When depositors put money in your bank, where do you get the money to pay in interest?
Well, a bank makes its money by giving loans to responsible people who have collateral and charging interest on the loans.
How much interest do you charge?
6%.
That's awfully high, isn't it?
6% interest is standard.
It is?
Yes.
Seems awfully high to me. Suppose some person came along and charged less interest than you do. Well, I bet pretty soon they'd take all your business away from you, wouldn't he? Mr. Bimble, you've given me something more valuable than money. You've given me knowledge. Thank you, Mr. Bimble.
Recruiting more dealers.
At a party, I see a lady who seemed to be very enthusiastic. She seemed to like people. She was a bubbly type of person. And I would say to her,
how much time do we have?
You know, I don't know if you've ever thought about doing any work outside your home, but you would be a terrific Tupperware lady.
Minutes, days, months?
When we were recruiting people, we tried to fill a need for something that they wanted, like I want new carpet or I want a new refrigerator, and then we would map out for them how many parties they would have to hold in order to get whatever it was that they wanted.
And after the party's over, I'll take a little extra time with you and I'll show you exactly what I sold.
Years? We don't know.
I will show you exactly what the Tupperware cost me, what the hostess gift cost, and you will see, when I have it all on a piece of paper, exactly how much money you would have made if you had done what you saw me do.
But this we do know. Civil defense is everybody's business. It's your business. Recently, Millard Caldwell, Administrator, Federal Civil Defense Administration, said, our danger at home is fixed and constant. Right at this moment, every major city in the United States is within reach of Russian bombers.
It was television.
We know that Russia has atomic bombs.
And now we add radio sight to sound.
We know that Russia has the facilities to wage biological warfare.
It was television.
America's finest
it
cigarette
was television.
Presents
Dead. Everything's basically disappeared. Dead.
By George, I've counted 11 antennas on the way downtown. Look at that house with three on it. They're ruining the architecture. Dead.
It does something to people.
Dead.
It takes hold of them. It roughs them up.
Dead.
It massages them. It bumps them around.
Dead.
It takes hold of them. It roughs them up.
Dead.
It massages them. It bumps them around.
Dead. Don't bring that into the house. I warned him it's gonna. When I was around 10 years old, I warned him it's gonna. My father bought a television.
Sorts from the major city areas, bounce them off a satellite and project them into a backward area where people can huddle around a television set.
World simultaneous information.
I warned him it's gonna create a separation, create a Berlin Wall in the family. It's gonna make my sister become a different kind of person. It's gonna make me become a different kind of person. My sister become a different kind of person. It's gonna make me become a different kind of person. My sister become a different kind of person. It's gonna make me become a different kind of person.
Cool is evolving, pop is not. Cool is evolving, pop is not.
Now, come on, guys, will you stop yakking? Take a break, stand up, stretch your legs, let's have a little music.
Everything's basically disappeared.
Yeah. I warned him it's gonna. I'll get into drugs. I'll get into drugs. I predicted all this when I was 10, but he couldn't understand that. He didn't believe me.
Yeah.
Don't bring that into the house.
That's right.
Yeah.
Don't bring that into the house.
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah, when are we getting one?
Leroy, we've led orderly lives up to this point. If we buy a television set, we'll spend every minute in front of it, eating our meals with cowboys and Indians, staying up all night watching.
Oh, boy, when do we get it? Oh, yeah?
Now, wait a minute. We're arguing about what we'll watch, and we don't even have a set. I'm not spending hundreds of dollars just to buy a gadget that starts arguing.
Now that's everybody wants.
And you know, I sort of wish I lived in those days again.
One of the big flips that's taking place in our time is the changeover from the eye to the ear.
Today we have a song entitled.
Now the point is, all times and places exist in electric conditions. Under electric conditions, all times and places exist. We call it nostalgia.
Everybody change. Yeah.
But we're just swimming in the sea of information, electrically retrieved, electrically present forever.
Out of that crypt. Miami, Florida, hello.
TV is far greater overkill than any
basketball. I think TV is wonderful.
Good. Rybrook, New York, hello.
When you're on the telephone or on radio or on TV, you don't have a physical body. You're just an image on the air.
Yeah.
When you don't have a physical body, you're a discarnate being.
We're fighting the images of ourselves in our attempt to understand the time we're living in now.
Yeah.
We're recovering these images and insisting on putting them in our time slot.
Yeah, when are we getting one?
So that we have a sense we still have a body. We don't have any bodies anymore.
Yeah, when are we getting one? Yeah, when are we getting one?
Tribal mandate.
The 50s did not exist, the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, they do not exist.
Yeah, when are we getting one?
We never left 1945.
Yeah, when are we getting one?
We've been running on the same spot.
I'm layering information on top of information.
I am resolutely opposed to all innovation, all change.
Yeah.
But I am determined to understand what's happening.
Yeah.
Because.
Yeah.
Because.
Yeah, when are we getting one?
Because. I don't choose to sit and let the juggernaut roll over me.
Turn off the mosaic mesh of fashion.
We're playing the old story backwards.
The name is Bachman. As technical as stuff along the last week, we're taking the Chicago
Bachman. We no longer have tactile interval addiction and gambling mania that's
spend all that money?
Running rampant on the planet today. If you just turn off the effect of the.
Why spend all that money?
This power program was
secretly taking control of the worldwide income inside, but I fall into that.
Just turn off the effective television mosaic mesh.
The only alternative is to understand everything that's going on.
Well, that's what I see.
Turn off as many buttons as you can.
If you want to see TV, we can go to somebody else's house and watch.
And frustrate them as much as you can.
Pretty soon everybody will have one but us.
Everything's basically disappeared.
But us.
The other shame about a delay is that it makes it hard or almost impossible to use one of the high fidelity calling devices. And if you do have to drop somebody, do you have to drop a whole big chunk of time, Izzy, or can you drop just a little piece of a word, or can you just like put a booper over an offensive word? And have you ever booped somebody in your career or censored them?
No, and I don't really know. I haven't heard it used, so I don't know what it sounds like when it happens, but it dumps 13 seconds. In other words, your show would stop, and then it would start again in real... No, it's got to go for 13 before it catches up again. I don't know what happens.
You want to practice?
All right, I have a button here labeled dump.
Okay, well, why don't I say something that's not totally dumpable, but...
No, you don't need to say anything. Let's just dump it and see where it comes back. I mean, from your home vantage point, what you hear happen.
Let's take a dump.
All right, those...
I think it's just going to repeat it.
Is this still live?
I think I'm hearing what it said repeated again, but I'm not sure.
Repeated? That would be self-defeating.
What was said just up to the part that you dumped, I think it repeated that once again.
But that would be the part I'm trying to dump, wouldn't it?
You know, I think I heard it say...
All right, listen, I'm going to say, my name is Izzy Isn't,
okay,
and then dump it, okay?
Okay, and I'll listen to...
Now, what are you hearing?
Yeah, I heard you say it.
You did?
Oh, wait. That was you saying that you were going to say it.
Well, that would be covered in 13 seconds. Maybe I'm wrong about the 13 seconds.
I'm not sure if you actually got it dumped.
What are you listening to?
I'm just listening both to you on the phone and I'm listening to the radio.
The radio.
Yeah, so on the radio side, I think I heard you say what you tried to dump.
You live in the California area.
I do, in fact.
All right.
Just on the edge of where you can be reached with a good antenna.
That's interesting. You know, there's no explanation of this dump button. One would assume, given no explanation, that you simply press it and you would dump what immediately happened.
That's what I would think, or at least 13 seconds worth, yeah.
If it's that many. Someone just told me that. I don't even know if that's true.
It sounds... A little bit less, maybe like 7 seconds to me.
But what happens on your signal?
Well, listening to it, it sounded like it didn't dump at all, like nothing at all happened.
Okay, when I say D-U-M-P, that's when I'm going... Now, what are you hearing?
Oh, got a blank, nothing that time. Yeah, you successfully...
Oh, because I
had the word dump that time.
I held it down.
You have to hold it down. Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, it's a button that springs right back up when you lift your finger off it. So I assume now you're going to have to hold it down to dump. What is how long do you have to hold it?
Maybe however long you hold it is how much you're actually dumping. So.
Oh, backwards? You mean previous?
Yeah. So if you hold it for 3 seconds, that will dump back in time 3 seconds. I'm guessing. Okay.
Now, you heard me say it on the phone. Did you hear me say it on the radio?
No, I didn't hear 3 seconds come on the radio.
All right. So, but then you'd have to guess. So it isn't any seconds. It's however long you hold it.
I think the rule of thumb would be however much time has passed since you heard the offending remark, you want to hold it a little longer than that.
That's guesswork. That's a lot of guesswork there, isn't it?
I bet it takes practice to become a good dumper.
It's okay if it just barely happened and you catch it quick, but if someone says, and a few other things are said and you're distracted and you're a little late, you'd have to guess how long to hold it. And then when it's being held down, you just hear silence, right?
Yeah, that's what we've been hearing when you hold it down.
I'm going to hold it down right now. You can hear this music. I'll turn the music up. Tell me if you're hearing that when I...
You effectively dumped that music.
So while it was held down, it was being dumped.
Yes.
What good is that?
But I think it also dumped just a little bit before.
It's very iffy, isn't it?
The first bit of music you played made it through, but the main loud music didn't at all.
Yeah. But that was while I was holding it down. I mean.
Yeah, that's sort of too late.
Please inform me when you're going to be obscene. Like right before.
Actually, you know what? I think you've used up your dump. Now the delay is very short.
It is?
Yeah, so I think, you know, if you hold it down or use it too much, you use up your delay, and there's got to be some way to recharge it. Or maybe it slowly tries to...
Yeah.
I don't know how.
I wonder how long it takes to catch up. All right, well, and this is how radio is done. Was done. We're almost done. Yeah, that's only like a few seconds.
Yeah, that's only like a few seconds.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's only like a few seconds.
Yeah.
Well, you better save your last few seconds, because who knows who will call in and what they'll say.
Well,
caller.
I swear to God damn it all, I'm not going to use it anyway. Who cares? Let them worry about it.
So here is the station manager, WMBD, Charles C. Cayley.
Thank you, Shrank, and welcome all of you visitors here to the Country Club.
Maybe if you dump all the time, then you won't have a delay, you know?
You mean dump the whole show?
You can just maybe, you know, dump every 5 minutes to me, because now the delay is getting longer.
We think we have a good afternoon's entertainment in store for you. And you're probably all wondering just what those pins mean that we've handed out that say HISDCWMBD on them. Well, you've probably figured out the WMBD part. Those, of course, are our call letters. But now it's a pleasure to tell you what the HISDC stands for. It means here is Smelly Dave, courtesy WMBD. I know you've been wondering about that, and I think you kind of enjoy the little joke we've had. Kind of created a little anxiousness among some of you. We want to just say a word or two about Dave, the great dead whale, which has been sent out here, and of course, which is on.
We'll be right back to that damn stinking whale in just a moment. This is KPFA and KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno, KZFR in Chico, KPFA.org online. This is Over the Edge. How Radio Was Done, Part 10 tonight.
We have our call completed, I believe, to Steve Bosco, our training camp reporter in Florida. I'm kind of excited today because, of course, the Red Sox are playing the Braves. It's another big game in the spring training series. And I'm sure, Steve, that you have a lot of news for us. Can you hear me okay?
Well, Bob, all right. This is Steve Bosco calling from Florida.
Can you jack Steve up a little bit? So better still pop him up down there.
Hello, Steve. Steve Bosco reporting from Florida.
Got a pretty good line today. What's new in the baseball world?
Hello, this is Steve Bosco down here in Florida.
Yeah, well, let's get to the news. We don't have too much time.
Hello, operator, would you check through on that call, please?
You don't need to check.
I can hear me fine, but I can't hear the other
Can you hear me, Steve? Hello.
Hello.
Steve, this is Bob and Ray speaking.
This is Steve Bosco. This is supposed to be on the radio.
This is on the radio.
Hey, Bob and Ray.
Hello, Steve.
Hello.
What's new?
Any baseball up there?
No, not up here. It's down there where you are.
Well, I know that, but I wonder if there's any baseball up there.
No, no. Uh-huh. Well, we do have a baseball down in the office there that we use during the summer on off hours.
You know. Hello. Yes, Bob and Ray. What'd you say?
How does the game look this afternoon?
What game is that, fellas?
What's that?
I said, what game is that?
Hello?
Hello, Bob and Ray?
Yeah, I'm not
sure. Steve Busco calling for Florida.
Yeah, I know it. How about
the
Rays and the Red Sox? They're playing this afternoon.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
You bet.
Yeah.
So that's about it as I see it for now, fellas. So,
have you talked with any of the managers or the players or anything around the hotel there?
No, we've got nothing in common.
Well, you're not supposed to have anything in common except an interest in baseball, and you're supposed to drag some facts out of them that you can give us exclusively.
Well, I don't know whether you can use this or not, but some of the pitchers down here, they throw with their right hand, and some of them throw with the left. Now, I don't know what you want to make out of that, unless it's a new technique.
We'll analyze it.
But it's, I don't know whether it's ever happened before, but I've noticed it two or three times.
Yeah.
But that's it. That's about all the news I have.
Yeah.
So, that money coming, boys. And I'll think of everything that happens in Florida. But time to sign out now. This is Steve Austin rounding first and being thrown out second.
First of all, we're going to call on our show business report award stuffer.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man made out of muscle and blood. A muscle and blood, skin and bone. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You know, since skin done, and what are you getting? Another day older and deeper and dead. Saint Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my suit to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up a shovel and walked to the mine. I rode 16 tons, I'm normal and cool. And the starboard said, Bella, bless my soul. You rode 16 tons, and what are you getting? Another day older and deeper and dense. Saint Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my suit to the company store. If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men didn't, and a lot of men died. I want to survive. The others still help the right one don't get you, then the left one won't be you. Sixteen done, and what are you getting? Another day older and deeper and dense. Saint Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my suit to the company store. I was born one morning and it was drizzling rain. Fighting the cover on my middle name. I was raised in a kingpin. An old mama line. Can't know how to make me walk the line. You know, 16 guns, and what do you get? Another day older and deeper and dense. Saint Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my through the company store. This is listener activated broadcasting from the Universal Media Network.
Something saying,
well, don't you know
that's the sound of the man.
chain gang. That's the sound of the men working on the chain gang.
All day long they're saying,
put, ah, put, ah, put, ah, put, ah.
They play now with their souls. Y'all
considered
rock and roll.
I
lost in the mashed potatoes, it was fine.
Oh, but now it's medicine time.
Mama keeps complaining about the real loud beat. I caught mama now patting her feet to rock and roll. Nah, 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 nah. Hey, children, rock and roll. Who cares what they say? Hey, rock and roll is here to stay now.
That was the first integrated setting I was ever in. But many, many parents and many children were scared of the words, the style, and the racial implications of black music. The irony is the adults who thought of rock and roll as an act of rebellion, while the kids said it's not, it's just music, those adults were right.
Chain gang. That's the sound of the men working on the chain gang.
All day long.
The condolences of every person at Pepsi Cola are with you. I got fired by my boss, Pepsi.
Pepsi-Cola.
And I nailed Jesus to the cross. Pepsi,
where
you gonna pay? Right. In the cupboard for 3 years.
Gonna make
you
soul
less
forever.
Alcoholic husband. Driving, frantic, wild, just
here. Can't sell you any artificial
sweetener. Poor old widow's house burned down. Pepsi. The genius of the soft drink world. Get the goddamn company to pay the bill. Tractors plowing down the hill. Pepsi.
Kids are drinking Pepsi
in the doorway. Cast this stench of puppy mill. Pepsi.
I feel like a Pepsi.
Well, yeah. She's with stinking urine.
You know it's hot beer.
Bloody shards of glass. Mud glass burned by fighting dogs. Drunkards passing gas.
And we'll see how much you sell.
Children dying of disease.
Presidential liberty. Pepsi was my power.
Pepsi,
yeah.
And I can't find the strength to taste Pepsi.
Forget it, forget it.
Medicated ointment being spread on painful rags.
Pick it up, drink it up.
Old outdated software. Getting thrown into the trash.
Up on Mississippi.
Everything still tastes the same. Pepsi.
We know that Russia is supplied with all the modern war gases. So long as these things are true, and every one of them is true, Fortress Main Street must be on the alert day and night. Civil defense is a national insurance policy. How much time do we have to prepare? We don't know. But this we do know. Civil defense is everybody's business. It's your business. Everybody's business. Just what is civil defense?
Quarters for the first Tupperware Jubilee.
It's your
Gonzalez, Gonzalez, I think I have it. I hear something.
A four-day extravaganza designed to build the loyalty of the Tupperware ladies.
I hadn't realized there were so many people in the Tupperware family. And to think there are more than 10,000 others who could not be here. It's just like a family reunion. 600 shovels on an acre of ground. And do we have fun? Watches, diamond rings, mink coats, television sets. We really strike gold.
I was so excited. I got on that shovel and I dug up that dirt and I hit a box and I pulled the box out of the ground, opened it up, and it was a double boiler, an Echo.
We still have
where? And I still have that from all those years. I just saved that little double boiler with a cover. I thought it was wonderful.
Well, now, what do you think?
That was crazy music, man. That sends me, Jack.
Woo! That music sends me, man. It sends me. You guys dig that music.
From Business Week thinking, well, you know, we're going to get maybe a column or a column and a half in Business Week because this is sort of unusual. And we wound up with the cover for the first time in the magazine's history, a woman on the cover.
Baby.
Happy, happy birthday.
Is this the line where you get the fat chicks at? Hello, Big Bertha. Big Bertha. This is Wally Whopper.
His theme music ready.
Looking for a pickle part.
Yes, here he is, ladies and gentlemen. Ward Stuffer, our roving critic. And what theatrical production do you want to talk about this time, Ward?
Well, Bob, last week I decided to stay home and take a look at a television commercial.
Then you're going to review that for us, huh?
Well, that's my intention, yes. Let's see. I have some notes here. Oh, yeah, here it is. Oh,
which one was it?
The stick-tight denture glue commercial.
Was it a good production, Ward Stuffer?
Well, let's see. I have the names of the actors listed here. A.J. Dove played the part of the denture wearer.
Mm-hmm.
Wanda Hemming, the disapproving wife. And Sid Maynard played the helpful pharmacist.
Well, in a nutshell, what did you think of it, Ward?
Well, I think A.J. Dove is a first-rate passeur. At commercial start, we see him seated at the dinner table, see?
Mm-hmm.
And he's just begun a very unusual meal.
Uh-huh.
The meal consists of corn, walnuts, and sour ball candies.
Well, that isn't exactly what you call a well-balanced
diet. Well, see, it was part of the plot.
Uh-huh.
At any rate, A.J. Dove starts the meal with the corn, see?
Mm-hmm.
And Bob, his finely shaded transition from smiling gentleman to slightly concerned person is really something to see.
I can imagine. I think I've seen this. What about Wanda Hemming, his disapproving wife? How is she?
She was magnificent, too. You see, while she has to register disapproval of A.J. Dove's discomfiture, she also has to show a modicum of sympathy, you know?
Well, why does she have to show sympathy, Ward?
Well, later, we learn that she once had the same problem as A.J. Dove, her husband.
Oh, does she reveal her secret to A.J. Dove in this scene?
No, not at first. After he finishes the corn, he's ready for the walnuts, see?
Yeah.
At this point, we find that the nutcracker is missing.
Yeah, that sounds kind of contrived.
Yes.
Somebody figured that way.
I thought it was the only unbelievable note in the whole production.
Yeah.
But it was worth it because A.J. Dove plays this sequence to perfection.
He does, huh?
Yeah. His bending and stooping to pick up something off the floor as he eats the walnuts is high comedy at its best.
And he hasn't even gotten to the sour ball candies yet, has he?
Well, no, he never gets to the sour ball candies because by this time he's holding a napkin over his face.
Oh,
see?
Yeah.
And it's here that Wanda Hemming tells A.J. Dove of her secret.
Well, how does she do that, Ward?
Well, she reaches across the table and touches his hand. And with her other hand, she reaches into her purse and takes out an empty can of Stick Tight and places it on the table.
And he knows?
Yes, I was drained by the scene. It was that powerful.
Ward, I think earlier you mentioned Sid Maynard is playing the helpful pharmacist.
Yeah, well, in the next scene, we see A.J. Dove and his wife Wanda Hemming in a drugstore. A.J. Dove is asking Sid Maynard, the helpful pharmacist, a good many questions in front of a counter full of Stick Tight.
Well, what's Sid Maynard like, actually?
Well, a gray-haired, helpful man. We see him talking earnestly to A.J. Dove, trying to convince him of the adhesive qualities of Stick Tight.
Oh, yeah.
Bob, the commercial ends with Sid Maynard, the helpful pharmacist, reaching into his own pocket and extracting
a can of Stick Tight. And that convinces A.J. Dove, and he buys some.
You saw the commercial?
No, but I know how writers work in this medium. Thanks very much, Ward Stuffer, for your review of a very moving commercial, and we'll look forward to the next visit.
Why, that's the car for me, Harlow.
You mean that new Packard that just passed, Jim?
Yes, sir. That's the popular price Packard Clipper. The power and luxury that only Packard can put into a car. And have you seen the Packard Patrician? That's the finest car ever to bear that famous Packard name.
A name we're privileged to salute tonight on Suspense. Packard, an outstanding member of our worldwide Autolite family.
Well, Packard is outstanding in every way. Its ruggedness and dependability have withstood the most tortuous tests that Packard engineers can devise. Packards have proved over and over that they have what it takes under every road and weather condition. Yes, sir, Harlow. When you get an Autolite-equipped Packard, you get real value. And you get a car with one of the most famous of all fine car names, Packard.
Yes, and Autolite is proud of its long association with Packard and with Packard dealers everywhere. Now, Satellite brings back to our Hollywood soundstage.
Yeah, and just to think it all began with one little old commercial announcement on WNBC just 30 years ago.
To Victor Mature in Elliot Lewis's production of The Girl in Car 32, a tale well calculated to keep you in suspense.
Well, advertising certainly has made a big change in American life.
Yes, sir. Way back before that first commercial, people lived their lives according to fiction stories, popular novels, that sort of thing.
For instance, boys patterned their lives after Frank Merriwell, Tim the Bootblack, Phil the Fiddler.
Girls lived the way girls did in Little Women, Black Beauty, the Motor Girls in Arizona.
But today, people live according to advertisements. Advertisements from newspapers and magazines, radio and television.
And to illustrate this, we present a documentary drama entitled Albert in Adland, or Albert Armstrong, the All-American Copy Boy.
We first meet Albert at the age of 2 months, sitting erect in his crib, studying the Good Housekeeping seal of approval.
Cool. Cool. Poor me. All covered with this nasty, prickly heat. If I could only tell Mummy about Bartlett's baby bomb. Oh, boy, I'd be a Bartlett's bomb baby.
We next meet Albert when he's 6 years old. His father and mother are worried, but they are talking over the problem sensibly and calmly, the way people do in a full-color ad in the Saturday Evening Post.
Father, I'm so worried about Albert. He doesn't jump and run and play like the other boys, and he's so skinny and nervous and underweight, and all he does is mope around the house all day reading Dostoevsky and won't even eat his Swiss chard.
Mother, may I say what's in my heart?
Please do, Father. You are so wise.
Why don't we try C23 vegetable juice cocktail? C23 contains the juice of Swiss chard, turnips, parsnips, kale, rutabaga, and 18 other horrible vegetables. It'll soon bring the paste back to his pasty little cheeks. So they do. No time at all, Albert is running and jumping and playing and snitching bicycles from the school racks.
Instead of being nervous and underweight, he's a fat slob.
And then, when he grew older, he met Althea. Many a happy afternoon they spent at the beach, smearing each other with gummo suntan lotion. And finally, one lovely night, Althea and Albert danced on the moonlit veranda at the country club.
Hey, Althea, darling, are you happy?
Of course I'm happy, Albert. And not only am I happy, but my pores are happy. That's because I use no-fast complexion soap.
Clever girl, Althea.
Oh, Albert, darling, when did you first know that you loved me?
The moment I saw your Squeezo toothpaste smile. Squeezo is the only toothpaste that makes a girl's teeth shine in the dark. It contains phosphorus.
Yes, they were so happy. But then, as lovers will, they quarreled.
Why can't you smoke aristocrat cigarettes like the smart set do, you crumb?
Ah, your dresses are never color bright. No wonder the guys down at the pool hall make wisecracks all the time.
But Albert went to see his friendly dentist. And fortunately, Althea had some pretty unkind friends who didn't mind telling her. And so they were married.
Althea was luck lovely as she clutched him with one hand and held her national silver plate under her arm. They were deliriously happy in their own little home. Night after night, they tested wax tapers together.
This is a very popular pastime among young married couples in Adland, testing wax papers to see which keeps bread tasty fresh longer.
Yes, married life in Adland was an endless round of gaiety.
However, middle-aged retirement at 55 came at last. Albert and Althea moved into the personal security retirement stage of life.
We find Albert dressed in a fishing outfit as Althea is puttering in the garden.
Now, in those ads, you'll remember, the gray-haired husband is always going fishing, and his wife, wearing eyeglasses, is always puttering in the garden.
Are you going fishing, Albert?
I gotta, Althea. We gotta have something to eat.
Well, I hope you catch something. I'm getting awfully tired of eating the roots in this old garden.
Sometimes I'm almost sorry we took out that age 55 personal retirement plan. I'd rather have some money instead of that hoe they gave you and this fishing rod they gave me. I should have read the small print at the end of the contract.
But have no fear. Even if they do starve to death, this couple in Adland need not worry. For the Slumber Glen pay-as-you-go memorial plan gives them peace of mind as they face the sunset.
Well, we sort of make it our business on the air to kid advertising and commercials, but the fact remains that none of the programs we've been talking about tonight would be on the air if it weren't for advertisers and sponsors.
Including Bob and Ray.
And here's the man who can tell you about that situation a lot better than we can, Mr. Charles Barry, Vice President in charge of radio and television programming for the National Broadcasting Company.
Thank you, Bob.
Thank you, Ray. In radio, we're usually too busy looking toward the future to think about the past. But now and then, there's a time to stop to think about what has been accomplished and of what we hope to do. When the first radio commercial was broadcast over station WNBC 30 years ago, it opened up new opportunities. The years that followed were filled with a spirit of adventure and accomplishment. New programs became American institutions, and new stars became the friends of an entire nation. Those years are filled with bright memories for those who planned and took part in the programs, and for those who listened to them. We've recalled some of those memories tonight. But tonight, we're looking forward with determination to fulfill the hopes of those radio pioneers who had such brave dreams only a few years ago. Through the will of the American people, a system of broadcasting was devised in which radio could bring everyone the finest in entertainment, news coverage, and public service programs. That system, supported by advertising, has made billions of dollars worth of radio service available to every home without cost. As General David Sarnoff has said, the richest person cannot buy for himself what the poorest gets free by radio. We're glad that WEAF, now WNBC, the key station of the National Broadcasting Company, has played such an important part in the development of radio broadcasting. And through our program, we have had the happy privilege of visiting you in your home through the many years. We hope most sincerely that we will deserve your friendship in the years to come. Thank you very much.
That was Charles Barry, Vice President in charge of radio and television programming for the National Broadcasting Company. And this is Bob Elliott saying, right if you get work.
Ray Goulding saying, hang by your thumb.
When it comes to blunting your taste for the normal, we're on the grinding edge. The Universal Media Network.
This has been the Billion Dollar Show, a special recorded and transcribed program on the 30th anniversary of the first radio commercial. Today, radio sponsors bring you $1 billion worth of entertainment each year. This program was produced and directed by George Wallach and written by Jack C. Wilson. This is Arthur Gary speaking.
Beating it out, folks, and the old Moondog Rock and Roll Party on Tuesday night is just getting underway. We've got a long way to go. 2.5 hours of your favorite blues and rhythm record show for all the gang in the Moondog Kingdom from the Midwest to the East Coast. And we'll continue in just a moment. This is WJW, WJW-FM in Cleveland. Head for the horn company tomorrow. Tell a Moondog sent you. Keep driving now. Head for the horn company tomorrow. Tell a Moondog sent you. Horns open daily from 7:30 in the morning till 6 at night with while you wait service. Be sure to ask for Moondog Snyder, the man with a big smile, easy credit terms, and fast service. That's the boy, Moondog Snyder, at the horn company service department, Carnegie and East 71st. This is WJW, WJW-FM in Cleveland.
We had a quarrel, a teenage quarrel. Now I'm as blue as I know how to be. I can't call you on the phone. I can't even see you at your home. So I'm sending you this present just to prove that I'm telling the truth. Dear, I believe you won't laugh when you receive this rose and a baby rue. I could have sent you an orchid of some kind, but that's all I had in my jeans at the time. But when we grow up, someday I'll show up, just to prove I was telling the truth. I'll kiss you too, then I'll hand to you this rose and a baby rose.
Oh, darling, I see. Your love here beside me, here to guide me. How can I go wrong? He sent you on to me, 'cause you were meant for me. I know you'll always be my real destiny. The touch of your soft hand, the kiss from your sweet lips, thrill me to my fingertips.
Once I would do it, it all made sense.
Rock and roll is cool, Batty, and you know it.
Chicago's steel mills and factories had lured thousands of blacks from the deep south with the promise of employment and a better life.
It's just fit perfectly.
There is a rose in Spanish Harlem.
Kids are dancing nowadays. They call it rock and rolling or bop or something like that.
It was a rebellion against suburbia. It was a rebellion for me against all of the conventions that seem to make life so stifling. And rock and roll, along with the beatnik movement, along with Kerouac and Ginsberg and things like that, it really helped to punch a hole in the 50s conformity.
Well, I'm sitting here wondering what
based upon the experiences throughout the country, that this rock and roll rhythm has been the seed of trouble, and we want to keep trouble out of Jersey City, Don.
Rock and roll has got to go, and go it does. That's the best way I know to get rid of them.
Point 25 of the communist goal, corrupt American young people, how? Through movies and music.
They stumbled upon an inspiration that in a few years' time would thrust them into the new world of rock and roll.
We went down to a rehearsal at Johnny Otis's and listened to his singers. He had a number of different singers down there. He had Mel Williams and Little Esther and Big Mama Thornton. Big Mama got up and sang a song, and she just knocked us out.
Ten late, Daddy. Big Mama's got to go. Be back later just to satisfy your soul. They call me Big Mama because I weigh 300 pounds.
She was so nasty. She had all these razor scars all over her face. I loved her. We looked at each other and decided to take off.
That two-beat pattern is the music brought to the United States of America by the communist conspiracy to corrupt teenagers, and it's in every rock and roll number.
But it can't be. People have been brainwashed and free America.
Communism. I mean, the idea that rock and roll has anything to do with communism. Rock and roll is sort of the ultimate flower of capitalism.
Well, I was still the maestro's champion, the chairman of the Universal Language League, fighting to keep music free of politics.
And naming her Businesswoman of the Year.
He didn't have a chance.
Well, you know, we were kind of happy.
It was working, even better than they had hoped. The product, the plan, and the person.
For certain words, for example, whether we hear them or whether we read them, to which we have been conditioned to respond from our earliest childhood in a favorable way. There are other words to which we are conditioned to respond in an unfavorable way.
You're gonna be a son of a gun.
You know that yesterday I said I was gonna be telling you about brainwashing in the United States. And I know some people must have said, well, Philbert, now you're going way out on a limb. This can't be. We know, of course, been brainwashing in slave labor camps in the Soviet Union or in Red China, but it can't be that people have been brainwashed in free America.
Among them were many musicians raised on country blues.
I felt proud for the Soviet people, for the Soviet working class.
Tick, 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 tick. How can anything go wrong?
For Soviet science, because of the short period in which we managed to acquire such weapons.
The feeling was, we made it, you know. Now we feel ourselves better. We could talk to the Americans on a more equal footing.
She's a red-headed atom bomb baby, a fortified blockbusting gal.
That was the feeling after it was officially announced.
Action drives the same man mad. She's used her TNT tactics.
Испытательный взрыв.
The first Soviet atomic bomb tests didn't promote a better relationship between the Soviet Union and Western powers. That's obvious. But it would have been much worse if the Soviet Union hadn't had its own nuclear bomb. Above all, the Soviet Union would have been in a worse situation.
In the U.S., confidence in American security was shattered. Most people had believed that Soviet scientists would take many years to catch up, if they ever could.
We were very ignorant of just how good the Russians were. We all like to think they're just a bunch of bearded Bolsheviks throwing throwing conventional bombs around, Molotov cocktails, all thumbs who couldn't do anything of any consequence. And they certainly told us that was not the case.
It would take a secret weapon or a Superman to harness her energy. There's no if, no, or maybe.
For example, the communists accuse us of being super Americans, we're super patriots, we are chauvinists and all that sort of thing. Go through the guide to subversive organizations, their own list of names. And what is the word they use more than any other word to apply to their own subversive organizations? American. American. Over and over again. Why? Because they believe in America? Of course not. That's ridiculous. This is a word symbol, a grouping of letters to which we here in this country have been conditioned to respond to in a favorable way.
At last.
From Mars? You really in radio contact with Mars?
Yes, Gonzalez, it's Mars. This message is man's first communication with the planet Mars.
Pero, why they say?
This is phenomenal. Positively amazing. Here they are, listen.
Do you know what to do in case of a civil defense emergency? You must know these two numbers, 640 and 1240. They may save your life.
And we jumped in Mike's car and headed for his house. We landed, and Mike went to the piano, and I started yelling. The song came together in about 8 or 10 minutes.
How did you sing it?
How did I sing it?
Okay. You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Like that.
That's how he sings.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
In 1953, black record buyers made Hound Dog a number one rhythm and blues hit. 3 years later, it would find a different audience.
Izzy isn't not his name. Izzy isn't Izzy. Izzy.
It's inconceivable that a music that's based so deeply in hustling, in let's get rich, in one-hit wonders, could have anything to do with a planned economy. I mean, the concepts are, you know, monumentally different.
You'll find words like peace and freedom and democracy. What do they call their slave nations in the Soviet Union? People's democracy. These are cybernetic symbols or Pavlovian symbols designed to get a favorable response. How about the word peaceful coexistence? Not an American term, it's a Russian term. First used by Lenin way back many years ago, then used by Stalin, now being used by Khrushchev.
Lead to responsible positions. And
how I've waited for this moment, rat-a-tat, to be by your side. Your best friend wrote and told me, rat-a-tat, you had teardrops in your eyes.
Should be avoided unless one will be satisfied with employment in manufacturing. Because radio broadcasts are so popular, the public demands prompt and efficient repair service to radio sets. This has created a large field of employment. However, the supply of radio servicemen generally exceeds the need, and this makes it extremely difficult for any but the well-trained to succeed in the work.
On a Tuesday afternoon, all I could do was cry. I made a promise that you treasure. I made it back home to you. How I've waited for this moment to be by your side. Your best friend had teardrops in your eyes.
Radio tuned to rock and roll. The stick was playing. Bazoom. The moon was shining bright. I heard someone saying, bazoom. Oh, what a lovely night. I turned around and bazoom. I saw you standing there.
I saw her standing on the corner. A yellow ribbon in her hair. I could not keep myself from shouting. Why, look at there.
To one night in heaven.
Bazoom.
That's all I ever got from 8 till 11.
Bazoom.
That's about it for How Radio Was Done, Part 10, tonight on Over the Edge. We'll be back next week with Part 11. This is KPFA, KPFE in Berkeley, KFCF Fresno, KZFR Chico, KPFA.org online. Stay tuned for the Puzzling Evidence Show, right here on KPFA.
I've been going crazy searching for my love and baby, going up and down the street and asking.
asking everyone I meet if they have seen an angel anywhere with pretty